joy to the world. The Lord has come. Merry Christmas from all of us here at Fort Myers Christian Outreach Center. You've unwrapped the gifts. It's time to relax, pull up a chair, and allow yourself to be blessed with the anointed presentation. Christmas is a family thing. This is the crew. They put it together, and we're going to celebrate Jesus. Happy birthday, Jesus. From Fort Myers Christian Outreach Center, our pastoral staff, our crew, and all of us here. Amen?
Amen.
Stay tuned now. We're going to go right in, and you're going to enjoy this presentation. Be blessed, and have a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Fairy tales for us. We want a real bedtime story. So we're going to tell you the amazing and miraculous story of Jesus's birth. Along the way, you will learn the answers to some challenging questions about the Christmas story. And all the answers are right from the Bible.
My own brew. I had to stop at Starbucks.
Always the case. There's always one in every group. Hey, listen. Since we're all here, it's time for a story.
Yeah.
Woo.
Okay.
Yay!
Can somebody be excited, please?
Yay!
Great.
You mean, from now on, I want you to tell me real stories about real people that and things that really happened.
But I thought you were that person that liked those stories that lived, ended with, and that lived happily ever after.
Sure, that's fine, as long as people really lived.
Okay, let me see here. We can make this happen. Let me see, you want fact and not fantasy. Okay, listen, it's almost Christmas. What if I tell you the true story of Christmas?
You mean Mary and Joseph? I think I already know that story.
You might know some of it, but okay, I'm going to test you right here, okay? What happened in the second chapter of the book of Luke, and who was the person they were talking about in that particular chapter?
The Virgin Mary?
Close, but no cigar. No, that's the first chapter. The second chapter talks about Caesar Augustus, all right? Now, in those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken and the entire Roman Empire had to go and be registered. And everyone went to his own town to register.
Was the month of August named for this Augustus?
Yes, it was, as a matter of fact. And guess what? The month of July was named for his great uncle, Uncle Julius Caesar, as well. See, back in those days, they wanted to make sure that everybody came. And what we want to do now is we want to show you that everything that happened really did happen. So if you check the history, you'll see that Augustus and Caesar were both there doing what they did, and that helps to validify that the Bible is real.
Really?
Wow.
Well, what was that business about going back to the hometown to register?
Well, it's something similar to what we do nowadays, just like when we just had an election, remember? And people had to go and they had to register in their cities so they could vote. Well, it's something similar to that. People had to go back to their place of birth and they had to register so they could be counted. Okay, let's read on together, okay?
So Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judah, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David.
Yes.
Why did Mary go along? He went there to register with Mary, who was engaged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
Right.
Wait a minute. I thought people have to be married first and then have children.
Yeah.
Slow down. Yes, well, that's the way it's supposed to be, but see, Joseph was not the baby daddy.
What?
The father was not a man.
He was just an ordinary baby. That's the way he planned it, maybe. Anything but common would have kept him apart. Apart from the children he came to rescue, limited by an elite few. He was the only child to ever ask to be born. He came to us with his eyes wide open, knowing how we're hurt and broken, choosing to partake. That we could come to him and not be afraid. He was ordinary with exception. His immaculate conception, birth and his death, they were planned from the very start. But between his entrance and his exit was a life that has affected anyone who's walked this earth to this very day. And with no airs of condescension, he became God's perfect extension, allowing you and me the chance to ever be so that we could come to him, so that we could come to him and not be afraid.
That Mary came from a city, Nazareth, all right, in Galilee. Now, Galilee was a beautiful place, hills, mountains, and, you know, fruitful valley. Also, it had a major sea, the Sea of Galilee. Now, her age, well, we don't know specifically, but we knew that back in the, during that time, most little girls got married between the age of 14 and 15.
Don't get no ideas over there.
Yeah. 14 and 15, but the father was not up there. The husband was a little bit older because he had to build up a nest egg to give to the family.
But why did God choose Mary to be Jesus' mother and not someone else?
Well, why not Mary? I mean, the Bible says that Mary was looked upon as being God's favorite child. So we see that because of that, God wanted to choose her to do something special. And the scriptures also tell us that Mary herself agreed to be the mother of Jesus.
Mm-hmm. somehow becomes alive. It moves. She knows that her baby has arrived. She's so scared, but she's so blessed. She lays down her fear for the hope at her breast. For she knows 1,000,000 chains could never hold back this moment in time. 1,000 dreams could never dream what this moment truly means. Heaven and earth, they cradle the infinite joy born on this night. For it only takes one child to forever change. He's so blessed. There's a thundering pride pounding deep in his chest. For he knows 1,000,000 chains could never hold back this moment in time. 1,000 dreams could never dream what this moment truly means.
Let me read some more for you, okay? Now, this is what the scripture says. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. A manger is a fitting place for animals.
Like what they use for horses, a stable?
Well, God's word didn't necessarily say that it was a stable, but based on what we believe that it was something very similar to that. Now, it tells us that back in those days that there were lots of caves that were used for stables, so it was probably something more like that.
Have they ever found the cave where Jesus was born?
Well, probably so. About for the last 1900 years, a lot of the Christians have been using the nativity scene that was there in this particular area and saying that that was the actual place. This was in Bethlehem, that this was the actual place of Jesus' birth.
I'd love to see that. Still, a stable is a miserable place to have a child if you're not a cow or a horse.
I totally agree with you on that. Yes.
Yeah.
estrella de paz. Sleep in heaven, sleep in peace.
The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Wow.
And this is the story of the very first Christmas. Remember, it's more than just a story or a tall tale. All of this really did happen.
Wow.
Wow.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining.
Praise His holy name, Christ.
Trust you've enjoyed this presentation today. We've done the best that we can to present a family issue. Yeah, it's important. You should not be alone today. We are the family of God. We hold each other up, and we are so glad to be part of God's family. So today, if you feel a little lonely, or perhaps it's just not a good day for you, or maybe you just like to pray with somebody, call the number on your screen. We have somebody ready to minister to you. It's Jesus' birthday. We're going to celebrate today. We invite you to come and join this family anytime you can on Fowler Street. Don't be alone. Be part of the family. God bless you. We invite you to next week, our watch night service on Saturday night, beginning at 9 o'clock. We have Prophetess Jana Alcorn bringing the word for 2017. And after that, we have an international feast. Make plans to be in the house of the Lord at 12 o'clock when we take communion and we bring in the new year. Hey, I'm Pastor Lynn Bracco. Gang here at Fort Myers Christian Outreach Center wishes you a very Merry Christmas and a blessed new year.